real examples. In this tutorial, I will not do an exercise, but I will simply show you a couple of real C-Web projects. The first is the project template for C-Web, and the second, the user terminal for a crack unit. Project template C-Web. The purpose of this is to provide to you a starting point for creating web pages for a generic application. We provide also a project template for C-Suite, that is for an application. Also in that case, the purpose is a starting point for a generic application. So we have two templates, one for the controller and the other for the web pages, that is the topic of this part. So first of all, we can download somewhere these two projects. We can start from this, the project template for C-Web. Of course, you can download from KSA C-Web area. They are in the templates tab. Here are the project template C-Web for PC and the project template for PGDX. So the first are pages designed to be used with a browser running in a PC, so with a big screen, let's say. While the second are pages designed for a small display, that is the one of the PGDX display, so 4.3 inch. Now we will use this one, so let's download it. We have two options. The first is download the source file, the one that we can open with the C-Web Builder. The second is download the HTTP files. So they are the files that we can simply copy into the controller as is in the HTTP folder. I prefer to use the first one. Download. Almost finished. Time I create a folder where to save, apologize, it is in Italian, anyway, new folder, project update C-Web. Then download, here is the file, here is the notes.db. Copied in the project template C-Web. Open in C-Web. Stop the server if running. Let's add a new project. The folder is C project template C-Web. It exists. Okay, I just created it. No, the problem is that there is already a project here with the same name. So I have to remove this first. Okay, try again. The folder is C. Template, select folder, okay. It's not empty because I just created the folder and copied the notes.db. So this is correct. Start. Starting project template C-Web. Here is started. Start the builder. So these are the pages. Now I don't want to explain all the details, the content and the purpose of all these pages. Also because it is more effective if we will see the pages running in the browser or shown in the browser. Anyway, we have a so just a half a minute of a quick view. A main page where to show the main variables. We can start and stop the unit here. In a folder there are some pages for the plant. Compression information, the body information, the trends also here, the main probes, the web PGD, regulation, okay, this is just a list of a sort of table with a list of the most important operating parameters, information of the devices. Settings, alarms, and this is interesting. In this page we will show the user manual. This is a PDF. This uses a foreign object. Okay, doesn't matter now. Some information, the version of the software and other things. Login. And some pages for setting clock, time, date, serial port, and so on. Okay, as I told you before, it's more effective if we see these pages running in the controller. So we can distribute. Now we can install also the application running in the controller, the software running in the controller. We can download from KSA, C Suite, Templates, Project Template, C Suite. We can, also in this case, we have two options. We can download the source file, open them in C Suite, and then using C Factory, if you know C Suite, you know also C Factory, you can upload it into the controller. Other option is without having C Suite, is use an upgrade package. Okay, here there are four upgrade package for CPICO, CPICO Mini, Core 0, Core 1, that is a two hardware revision. These are the source file of the project template for C Suite. Also in this case is a starting point for a generic application, not for a specific application, chiller, crack, whatever else, but generic application. Not important to see the details of this. I have already uploaded this application into the controller. I used an upgrade package. Anyway, not important, this is part of the C Suite training, not the C Web training. So now I have this project in the controller. I have distributed the web pages into the controller. Now we are ready to check. So refresh. Could be better to other tools, tools for developers, and empty the cache and reload manually, as we have seen in one of the first exercises. So we have a clean starting point. This is Italian, we can switch to English. This is the main page, where we can show the main information, main temperature, main set point. Anyway, it is a template, so you can modify it as you prefer according to your application. Here are status of the unit, working mode. We have a toolbar where we can log in. So this uses the same password that are used in the controller. Okay, we have the home. There is a sidebar in the unit. We can open the plant. Here we don't see the trend because I forgot to upload also the foreign object. If you have seen the previous exercise, we saw how to upload the foreign object, trend, alarms, and also the WebPGD. Oh no, here there is the WebPGD, so probably I forgot to copy only the foreign object regarding the trend. Okay, doesn't matter. Let's go on in the plant. Okay, some generic information of the valve compressor, one of the probe. Okay, the WebPGD that I just show you. Okay, another menu for the parameters. We have to log in. Okay, the password was already saved, so we log it in maintenance, so as a service. So a table for some parameters, another page for other parameters, for regulation, settings. Okay, I don't want to enter in all the pages. So the important is to understand what is the purpose. It is a template for a generic application. If you need more or less menu, for example, or more or less pages in a given menu, you can edit the sidebar according to your needs. But interesting is not the alarms, but in the info, user manual. In this case, we used the foreign object that I explained in the previous exercise to show a PDF, the user manual of this application or of the commission report or whatever else. In about, okay, some software details, version, name, and so on. So, I repeat. The project template CWeb, this one, and the project template CSuite, this one, are designed to work together. Both are starting point for a generic application. You can remove what you don't need and add what is missing. The other project that I want to show is the user terminal for a crack unit, computer room air conditioning. This is a real application, a real unit in our product development office. Also in this case, I don't want to go too much in the details. We have a home, is this page with the main temperature. We can, actually, I can't switch on the unit because it is in read-only mode, so I can't modify parameters, I can only see. Here is the envelope of the compressor. You can see that the compressor is at minimum speed. Psychrometric diagram. Okay, temperature humidity looks good. Some trends. Okay, doesn't matter to see the trends. Let's go on. Other temperatures, some information for input, output, expansion valve, compressor, fans, the alarms, virtual PGD, the web PGD, there is. Okay, I can't, in fact, is set in read only now. Last thing that we can see here is this. This is a link to the web kit. If you have seen the very first video, the introduction, I told you that the web pages created with CWeb, like this, require a license, while the web pages created, let's say, by hand, by other tools, like the WebKit doesn't need the license. The point is that they can be used together. This is a real example. We can jump from web pages created with CWeb into pages created with other tools. The third application that we could see is the service tool for the DC compressor chiller. This is a standard project, and you can download these pages from KSA, standard application, and here is DC compressor chiller. So from here you can download binary file for the application and the HTTP files. This file contains the CWeb pages, not the source file, but contains the deliverable, so the HTML file. So simply unzip it into the HTTP folder of the controller. I will not show you these pages from live because are very similar to the project template CWeb, because they are based on this project, so it's not worth to see these pages. Well, so we have seen two real examples, and that's all also for this tutorial. And this is the last tutorial of this set of tutorials, and thank you for watching.